மண்ணின மனசால் உழுது பொன்மணி நீள விதச்சு உன்மத ஹிருதயம் நன்னீரல பேடு என்னுள்ளில் நின்னுள்ளில் பொன்னர தீர்க்குவான் எங்கெங்கும் பொல்கதிராய் சொப்னம் தீர்க்குவான் என்னுள்ளில் நின்னுள்ளில் பொன்னர தீர்க்குவான் எங்கெங்கும் பொல்கதிராய் சொப்னம் தீர்க்குவான் பீமா பீமா
பீமா எம்ஜி ரோட் திருவனந்தபுரம் எலங்கத் காம்ப்ளெக்ஸ் திருவனந்தபுரம்.
When there were 2 days on 13th, the movie released on 15th. On 13th, I was damn nervous. I don't know why. I was like, will they accept? Will they not accept? We were getting very good reviews for the trailers, so I was a little confident. And it's Lal sir's movie, you know, so that assurance and the surety is there. But at this time, Lal sir was nervous, which was very weird for me to see. And he told me that in 25 years of his filmmaking, this is the first time he's so nervous for any movie. So when you hear that from the captain of the ship, you kind of get a little this thing. And I just wanted one thing. I wasn't sure if this movie was going to do well, it would be a hit, whether people would accept it. It's just that I didn't want to let Lal sir down. I wanted to make him proud because he's taken me. I have no connection with the industry. He gave me such a big chance. He put this much responsibility of a movie on me that there was no way that I could disappoint him. So I was just praying to God one day before. We went to all churches and temples and all. I just said one thing. I was like, I don't care what it does for me, but I just want to make Lal sir proud. That's all I want to do, because he's done a very big thing by giving me an opportunity like this, and I am very grateful. And mahabhagyam aanu enikku idru avasaram kitti. So I just wanted to make him happy and proud, that's all. And now looking at the responses, I'm so happy. He is happy, he's relieved. So that makes me happy. And plus the audiences are accepting me. That was another concern. I was damn scared if they'll accept me or no. But they're so sweet that they've accepted me and they've liked everything that I've done in the movie. So I'm super duper happy now. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing, but I'm completely different from Neena. I'm not Neena at all. Neena is completely like a guy, tomboyish. I was a past beauty pageant winner, so I was completely like a girl. Atra girly illa, but I was a girl, not at all like Neena. I would not drink and smoke. So there are a lot of things personality-wise and body language-wise which I was not at all like Neena. Neena is very on the face, very bold, very whacked out. She'll do anything without thinking, unexpected. But I'm not like that. I think twice, thrice. Like, I won't simply go and hit an auto car and if he does shit to me. I may probably just, you know, give him a bad word and run. Something like that. But I'll never go and be like, okay, come, I'll slap you. So yeah, Neena is very different than me in real life. But internally, Neena is the kind of a girl who's very free. She believes in freedom. She is someone who's not fake at all. What she is inside, she is outside. And I think those qualities are very much there in me. I'm a very simple person. I don't have too much to myself, actually. That is why I say that I'm not like Neena, because Neena is very complex. Nyan itra complex illa. I'm a very simple personality girl. I don't have too many, you know, inhibitions and things like that. So yeah, comparatively not, but inside, when you really see the real Neena, how she is, how she thinks, she's not fake. She listens to her heart, very impulsive. So those are the things I think I relate to. And not only me, I think every girl in Kerala will relate to those things especially. Okay, first thing, I love chaya. Okay, like I'm a complete chaya person. The first thing I get up in the morning is I need a chur chaya. So yeah, for me it was very natural to ask a chur chaya over there. And I drink 3 cups of tea a day, which is not good, apparently, according to my mom. But I can't give up tea. First thing in the morning I do is have tea. Then I have tea in the afternoon around 4-5, and then I end up having tea around 7-8 also. This is like my habit, which is there. So yeah, I'm a complete chaya person. And getting up late, as in, I love to sleep. I don't know who doesn't love to sleep, but I am a complete sleep person. Whenever my friends call me out for dinner, or you know, like a late night party, or sometimes you want to go and surprise our friends at 12, 1 o'clock in the night when it's their birthday, I'm the first person to sleep. And my friends hate that about me. That is why I have this name. It's the first time I'm actually revealing it to everyone. I don't know if you guys will use it against me, but my friends call me Sleepti. Because I never am in a position to chill. Whenever they want to go out and they're like, okay, you know, today we'll go for a drive, and then, you know, we'll come back and chill at our friend's place, and you know, we'll do this full night, you know, pajama party and all. And I'm like, yeah, yeah, let's do it. Suddenly when it'll become 11 o'clock, I'll start feeling little drowsy. Then 12 ho gaya. Somehow I'll try to extend it to 1, but that's it. I cannot, like at home also, 10:30, 11 and I'm off to bed. I cannot keep up like that. But I'm a kind of a person that if you don't wake me up, I'll not get up. So alarm doesn't work with me. I keep alarms on both my phones, then only I somehow kind of get up. So yeah, I'm a complete sleep person in real life, and a complete chaya person also. ഞാൻ ജനിച്ചതും വളർന്നതും മുംബൈയിലാണ്. കംപ്ലീറ്റഡ് മൈ സ്കൂളിംഗ് ആൻഡ് കോളേജ് ഫ്രോം ബോംബെ. ഐ ജസ്റ്റ് കംപ്ലീറ്റഡ് മൈ ബാച്ചിലേഴ്സ് ഇൻ ബിസിനസ് അഡ്മിനിസ്ട്രേഷൻ ഫ്രോം സേവിയേഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് planning to do my MBA in future. My Achan is very particular about it. I was going to give my GMAT also this year, but Lal Sir's movie happened, so adu korchu delay aayi poi. Later in life, I want to do my MBA and settle down. Maybe I'll become like a CEO of a company or something. I used to think like that, but now I don't know what's going to happen in the future. And I'm the kind of a person who likes to live in the present. I don't like planning my future that much. So yeah, I'm living my present and I'm enjoying it. Thanks to God. Actually, I was very nervous. Especially my dad watching the movie, because ende amma was always with me during my entire shoot. So korchu scenes ammeka ariya, amma even knows the story, but I made sure that my dad doesn't know the story. He knew that it's a tomboyish character. He knew I had to ride the bike, but I kind of didn't tell him about drinking and smoking. Yeah, I didn't tell my dad, honestly. Although I was doing a movie and everybody would have known, but through Facebook, my dad came to know in the middle of my shoot, and he's like, one day he's calling me and he's like, you're gonna drink and smoke for the movie? I'm like, no, Papa, I'm only going to smoke. Because smoking is something I have to show, but drinking I won't drink and all. He's like, are you sure you'll be able to do it? I don't want you to develop a habit. He gave me one big lecture on the phone, and I was like, trust me, I won't do anything like that. And you know, Lal Sir is there, and my dad has met Lal Sir, so he knows him also. So dad was very concerned. Achan is very strict, very protective. Nyan otta molanu. So my dad is very, you know, strict about me. And the irony of the situation is that my dad kind of treats me like a guy. So I'm a daughter and a son to him. So whenever he, you know, does anything adventurous, like, you know, he's going out with his friends on the bike, he'll always be like, aana hai teko, chal hum log bike pe chal rahe, chal tu bhi aaja, you know, all that kind of thing. But when it comes to, you know, talking to boys or probably going to college, because I was in a girl's school, like, entirely, like more than 12 years I was in a girl's school, and suddenly in college we don't have too many, you know, girls centric college, and whichever colleges were there for me as pertaining science were with co-ed. So my dad was so particular, he used to come every day to school, and I used to stay in Andheri, which is like 30 kilometers away from town. My college was in town, so he used to come every day to drop me. That protective my dad is. So for a dad like that, it was a little difficult to accept, but he understood that it was acting and he was supportive. And when he watched the movie, it's very emotional. He had tears in his eyes. So yeah, both my mom cried after watching the movie, but my dad also was very emotional. And for the first time, my dad was not critical about me. Otherwise, my parents are very critical because they want me to, you know, be better in what I am. So whether it comes to studies also, even if I get 95%, my dad is like, 5% kidhar gaya? Like, where is your 5%? He's like that. My dad is like that. So yeah, so I was nervous to show them the movie, but at the end of it, he didn't say anything. He's like, he only told me, how did you do that? Like, how did you do that? And I was like, I don't know. And he was very happy and he patted me on the back, and also I was, they're very emotional for me. They were very proud, actually. Intense, I have not liked anybody up till now. No, I haven't liked anybody intense. I have not yet fallen in love. Neena fell in love with VP. But maybe one day, soon, I may probably find someone, then I'll be in love. But I won't act like Neena. I'll just go and say, okay, I like you. And if he likes me, then okay, good. There's no need. Atra, I can't do like how Neena did. Tennila poovin ullam kavarum ilam kaate ivali poru kaate verude alayade aarum kaana tadu viralane kanivode neerum ninju talugamo alivode. Okay, Kanmani, I was like, Dulkar. Who doesn't think like that about Dulkar, sir? I don't know. But leaving all that aside, I think there are amazing performers and amazing actors in the Malayalam industry. If I really have to count on my fingers, first is Mammootty and Mohanlal. It's my very great wish to do a small scene with them. So maybe hopefully one day I can reach that much level that I can at least do one combination scene with both of them. So that's one, two people that are pakka on my list at the start. Apart from that, Dulkar, definitely Dulkar, Niven Pauly, Fahad Fazil, Prithviraj, Jay Surya, Indrajit, Vijay Babu, to I worked with only. Then basically everybody. One movie with each and everyone is possible, then yeah. It was very nice shooting in Russia, because as I was shooting, I got to visit a lot of places like St. Petersburg and Moscow and things like that. And after our entire, you know, shots were over for the title song, we got back from St. Petersburg to Moscow to take a flight. But our flight got delayed and we were like, you know, we all were very disappointed because Lal sir had planned the shoot in Cochin just 2 days later. So we didn't have time. So, but because of that, I happened to have my haircut in Moscow. Actually, I was supposed to come down to Bombay, have my haircut, and then the next day, I was supposed to leave to Kerala for the shoot. But because our flight got delayed for 24 hours, Lalsa was like, why don't we cut our hair here? And they were like, that's a good idea. So we went, we found out a very good place. We went, got my hair cut. And that's how the whole hair cutting Nina transformation process happened in Moscow. So I think it got delayed. We were very upset, but it happened all for the best. Nobody believes this, but I think the entire Nina team is like a family. And I'm not kidding. Velliya kudumbu. It is like a kudumbu. I never thought that I would ever feel like a family. I was little scared before coming here. But apart from Lal sir, Jomon, Anne, Vijay, I'm not even talking about them. Like keeping them aside from Babu Cheta, who was our spot boy, to our camera assistant, Basha Bhai, to the art assistants like Vishnu and everyone who start painting and everything. I was friendly with everybody. Go to anybody's Facebook profile, all of them are on my Facebook. I think I have had stories and funny incidences with everybody, and that's why I used to be treated like a kid in the entire, you know, team, especially whenever we used to shoot, and all of them were so nice to me, and I miss them so much. I just hope that in my future projects I get a team as good as this, because working with Lal sir is one of the best things, not only because of Lal sir but because of his entire team. My ADs, oh my god, my ADs, how much fun, don't even ask. The way they used to teach me my dialogues, my costumes, my everything, it was crazy. Vijay, he's a witty person. Like if you sit with him for 5 minutes, he'll make you laugh like anything. And there were so many times when me and Vijay have such emotional and such heavy scenes to do, and just 2 minutes before that we are like ha 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 laughing, and Lal sir is looking in the monitor and be like, enda mandatharangalana, you guys have to start to cry now in 2 minutes, what are you guys doing? So Lal sir was fully in, you know, fits and all, but at the end of it everything turned out well. So I had too much fun during Nina shooting. That's why when people ask me, was it difficult for you, was it challenging, actually it wasn't, because these guys helped me so much that I did not feel like it was a movie and it was some serious cinema happening. So yeah, I had a lot of fun. Niyanoda enna shoonu vilikkunnathu. നീ ആണോടാ എന്നെ ഷൂ ഷൂന്ന് വിളിക്കുന്നത്? അത് പറ പെണ്ണുങ്ങളുടെ ഷൂണ് വിളിക്കുന്ന കളിക്കണോടാ പട്ടി. നൗ ഇൻ ഹിന്ദി, നൗ ഇൻ ഹിന്ദി ആൾ ഡു ഇട്ടോ. തൂനെ മുജെ ഷൂ ഷൂ കർക്കെ ബുലായ, തൂനെ മുജെ ഷൂ ഷൂ കർക്കെ ബുലായ, പെലെ വോ ബോൾ. ലഡ്കിയോ കോ ഷൂ ഷൂ കർക്കെ ബുലാത്ത കുത്തേ. Martin was more nervous than me, actually. I don't know why Martin was so nervous to do the scene. He was perfectly good for it. He was very quiet and all. Actually, Martin doesn't talk too much and he's very shy, okay? I don't know. He's damn shy as a person. So he didn't speak to me so much. But when he came to Coorg and we had that combination scene, it was quite a long scene. So in that, we really became very close, and he's actually a photographer. So I asked him, can you please take some stills from me and all, because I'm a model. So whenever I see a photographer, I'm like, okay, can I model? Can I pose? So we've become like good friends. His next movie, Jomon is doing his next movie. So he was talking a little bit about that also. It was with Dulkar. So he's damn nice. He's damn fun, but very shy, actually. Very shy. He was so nervous. He looked like a first time actor, but at the end of it, he used to be nervous before the shot and he used to be like, okay, ingane aanu, like that and all. But at the end of it, when he used to give the shot, it used to be perfect. And then when sir used to say cut, he's like, perfect illa, and sir is like, Martin, best on a best in the world. So it used to be like that with Martin, sir. But he's damn nice and very sweet. Okay, secret is when Lal sir told me that I had to cut my hair, he was really worried and scared because the moment I opened my clip, no, my hair was like very long. I had like this much long hair and thick hair. My mom, mallu hair I have basically. My mom's jeans have gotten into my hair. So I have mallu hair. So Lal sir was very sad. Lal sir ka vilare sanganam toni when he had to cut my hair. But when I was on set, every 4 days my hair would grow and every 4 days I had to trim my hair. So at one point in time, Lal sir is like, he's like, so itre how come your moody is growing? Like I told Lal sir, no tension. Even if you get my hair short, my hair grows, no problem. So Lal sir is like, okay, if you say so, fine. But then when I started shooting, Lal sir is like, ayyo, again trim chenam, again trim chenam. So I have trimmed my hair 40-day schedule, basically 39-day schedule. I have trimmed my hair 11 times. 11 times in 39 days. So my hair grows that fast. So I think to grow my hair up till remember me, I think 1.5-2 months. It's already growing, by the way. I'm not trimmed it now, so. Actually, my family in Bombay, they're very culturally different, very different. My mom, caste, creed, religion, everything is very different. But one thing that is very good about my parents is they've included both. I'm very much, attached to Kerala, that I'm attached to my Pahadi culture. My mom completed her graduation and I think she was only like 19, 20 when she left Kerala and came to Bombay to work as a banker. She used to be a banker, she used to work in the bank before, so the State Bank of India. So she was working and my dad did his chartered accountancy and he started working and he had come to the State Bank of India to check their records because, you know, chartered accountants go and check their audits and everything. So he had his regular checks in State Bank. So that time my mom was a new joinee. I think just 6-8 months since she joined the bank and my dad came there on audit basis and it was my mom who was giving him the drafts to check and everything. So that's how he saw my mom and everything. And he complimented my mom on her smile. That's how first thing my dad said, don't mind, but you have a beautiful smile, you should try for ads. My mom is like, okay. Honestly, I don't know why, if anybody says what do you like about you the most, I don't know what I like about me the most. I think I'm pretty average looking only. But I used to like my hair and I still like my hair. It's not like I don't like my hair. It's short, but my hair is the same. So if there's one thing out of my entire physical structure that you ask me, I like my hair the most. I like an Indian sari the most. Indian sari can look traditional, it can look very beautiful, it can be worn in different ways and it's very versatile as a garment. So if I have to choose one udupu that I really like the most, I think for a girl, I think it's a sari, and especially the Kerala sari with white and the golden border. I think it looks very classy. When I got my first check for my first film, the first thing I went is we went to a temple, prayed, and like that I'm very God, not fearing, I'm very God loving because I think that He's really blessed me for something like this. So I went and I prayed and I handed over completely to my parents. So I have not taken one pie from it. I think they are more deserving than me. So the first thing I did is, my dad was not there here unfortunately when I got my check, but my entire money that I've earned for my first movie or the first thing that I've done in the cinema, I've given it to my parents. So I didn't buy them anything, but they can buy anything they want. Lal sir would be like sitting like this. Shot ready or no? Ready or no shot? Babu! Cigarette every day. Cigarette. Ready or no shot? Enta mandata rangalana idu. ഇപ്പൊ ടൈമില്ല, 6:30 ആയി. ഷോട്ട് റെഡി ആണ്. ദീപ്തി, ദീപു, ദീപു, ഷോട്ട്. ഓക്കെ, ആക്ഷൻ. Cut it. That is how Lalsar is. He will, when he's happy, cut it. When he's not happy, cut it. So me and Vijay, when we are there, we don't need to come to the monitor only. When Lalsar says cut it, we are like, good, good job. Everything is fine. But when Lalsar like cut it, we're like, unnugudi. So yeah. റാഫി, കോസ്റ്റ്യൂം എവിടെ? ഷോട്ട് റെഡിയാണ്. ലാൽ ചേട്ടൻ, ആ ഇപ്പോൾ എന്ത് ഷീട്ട് ദിസ് തിങ് ആൻഡ് ഹി കോൾസ് മീ ഢക്കൻ ബൈ ദ വേ. സോ ഹി ബി ലൈക്ക്, ഏ ഢക്കൻ, ഷോട്ട് റെഡി. ആ ഓക്കെ, കം കം, വിൽ പ്രാക്ടീസ്. ബാബുട്ടാ, ഹൗ ആർ യു ബാബുട്ടാ? എവറിത്തിങ്സ് ഫൈൻ. ബിലൈക്ക്, ആ എങ്ങനെ വിശേഷം? ഓക്കെ. ബ്രേക്ക്ഫാസ്റ്റ് എവിടെയാണ്? ഓ, ബ്രേക്ക്ഫാസ്റ്റ് എവിടെയാണ്? ഓക്കെ. ഒരു ചപ്പാത്തി, കുറച്ച് മീൻ കറി, കുറച്ച് ചമ്മന്തി, കുറച്ച് ഇത്ര. ഐ തിങ്ക് യു ഷുഡ് ടേക്ക് ദ ചമ്മന്തി, ഇറ്റ്സ് വെരി ഗുഡ്. ബാബുട്ട, കുറച്ച് ചമ്മന്തി ഇവിടെ. ഹി ഈസ് ലൈക്ക് ദാറ്റ്, ഹി ഈസ് സോ റെസ്റ്റ്ലെസ്. നൗ ഡോണ്ട് ആസ്ക്, ബട്ട് ഇറ്റ്സ് ടു മച്ച് ഫൺ വിത്ത് ഹിം. യാ, സോ ലൈക്ക് ദാറ്റ്. ഐ സ്റ്റിൽ റിമെമ്പർ വി വെന്റ് ടു കൂർഗ് ആൻഡ് ഓൾ, ആൻഡ് എവറിബഡി ഈസ് മീറ്റിംഗ് ആഫ്റ്റർ സെക്കൻഡ് സ്കെഡ്യൂൾ. എവറിബഡി ഈസ് ലൈക്ക് ഹായ്, ഹലോ, ഹൗ ആർ യു, എങ്ങനെയാണ്, സുഖം, എവറിതിങ്. സോ ഹി വെന്റ് ടു ബാബു ചേട്ടാ. And he's our spot boy, and Babu Cheta was like, you know, namaskaram and all. So Vijay was like, hello Babu Cheta, engne aanu, okay, they like wished him and all. So Babu Cheta was like, Vijay Babu is wishing me, matlab kya hai. So it's like, okay, breakfast evade. Breakfast evade. We all started laughing because he was so, he took Babu Cheta's hand, wished him hello, good morning, breakfast evade. So Babu Cheta was like, അവിടെയാണ് സർ, അവിടെ. സോ യാ, വിജയ് ഇസ് എ വെരി ബിഗ് ഫുഡി ആൻഡ് ഹീസ് ഡാം ഫൺ ആൻഡ് വെരി ഇംപേഷ്യൻറ്റ്. ബട്ട് താങ്ക്സ് ടു ലാൽ സർ, ഹി ഹാസ് ഗോട്ട്, ഹീസ് ബിക്കം വെരി പേഷ്യൻറ്റ് നൗ. ബിഫോർ ഹി വുഡ് ബി സോ ഇംപേഷ്യൻറ്റ്. ഐ സ്റ്റിൽ റിമെമ്പർ ദർ വാസ് വൺ സീൻ ഇൻ വിജയ് ബാബ്, ഇൻ വിച്ച് ഐ ആം സ്ലീപ്പിംഗ് ഇൻ ദ കാർ ആൻഡ് വിജയ് ഹാസ് ടു കം ആൻഡ് വെരി ജെൻറ്റ്ലി ടച്ച് മീ ഓൺ ദ ഫേസ്. So I was sleeping, so I'm supposed to close my eyes, and also Lal sir was like, okay, action. So I don't know anything. So I'm closing my eyes, suddenly I'm feeling something coming close and thak. And I'm like, who slapped me? And Lal sir like, cut it. Lal sir's like, endana ni cheyanam Vijay, oru with pranayam you have to do slowly, adu venda, she's sleeping, you're not supposed to do that. So she's like, oh, angleyanu. Oh, okay, once again. And then I was sitting like this, like, okay, go sleep, Dhakkan. And I'm like, okay. So these are the things that were going behind Nina's this thing. So he was very playful. We are like big, we become big buddies now. He keeps teasing me, I keep teasing him. So when I see the movie now, I'm like surprised as to how we did that, because it used to be too much fun in the background. And Lal sir used to be very tensed all the time because of that. But Lal sir enjoyed also, because he used to have so much of fun sitting on the monitor and observing Vijay and me. We used to keep fighting, joking, playing, everything possible under the sun. ഇരവിൽ കൂട്ടായി ഞാൻ ഇല്ലയോ, ഞാൻ പാടും താരാട്ട് പാട്ടില്ലയോ, ചിരി തൂക്കൂ നീ എൻ ജീവനേ. From start, he is not at all musically inclined. Vijay oru pakka kachavadakaranaanu, pakka kachavadakaranu, okay, he's full businessman. So he, this song creativity, athu ஒட்டும் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் இல்லை விஜய்க்கு. ஸோ லால்சா செட் சி யுவர் மோஸ்ட் டிஃபிகல்ட் சீன்ஸ் ஆர் கோன் டு பி தீஸ் ரொமான்டிக் அண்ட் எமோஷனல் சீன்ஸ், ஸோ யூ பெட்டர் லேர்ன் ஹவு டு டூ இட். அண்ட் ஹீ ஹேஸ் டு லிப் சிங்க் தட் தே நீல பூவம் சாங். ஸோ ஃபார் தேட் ஹீ நீட்ஸ் டு லிப் சிங் அண்ட் டூ த கிட்டார் அண்ட் ஆல். ஹீ வாஸ் ஓ கான்ஃபிடென்ட். அது செய்தோம் நோ குறப்பில்ல குறப்பில்ல நோ ப்ராப்ளம் ஆல் டூ இட் அல் டூட் ஒன் டே பிஃபோர் ஆல் டூ இட். லால்சா இஸ் லைக் சி விஜய் யூ ஹாவ் டு டூ இட் ப்ராப்பர்லி. அது பட்டனில் செய்யணும் ப்ராப்பர்லி, எனக்கு ப்ராப்பர் ஸ்ட்ரம்மிங் வேணும். ஸோ இஸ் லைக் நோ ப்ராப்ளம் நான் செய்தோலா. ஸோ ஆஃப்டர்ஸ் லைக் ஓகே நைட் ஷூட், தேட் வாஸ் த நைட் ஷூட் தட் வென் த லாங்கஸ்ட் பிகாஸ் விஜய் couldn't lip sync it, he couldn't do it because not at all inclined, plus he had to play the guitar, he had to lip sync, he had to give emotions, plus he had to get up with the guitar and play the guitar and come and sit next to me. So for Vijay it was very difficult and I was laughing because Lalsa was like on the mic, he was giving nice, I don't want to say very. So I was sitting and laughing and laughing, and whenever Vijay gets shouting, I laugh the most. Lalsa is like, Endra Santosham Anile. Whenever Vijay gets shouting, Endra Santosham. The moment Vijay will get shouting, no matter wherever I am in the set, I will start laughing there. Then everybody will be like, there, Dipti started laughing. It used to be too fun, but Vijay was a complete sport. He never took it seriously, and at the end of it, we got a good shot. So. Actually, luckily I've got a couple of offers. But I want to do something completely different than Neena. That's my agraham. எனக்கு ஒரு டிஃப்ரெண்ட் கேரக்டர் செய்யணும். பட் ஐ ஆம் வெயிட்டிங் ஃபார் த ரைட் ஸ்கிரிப்ட். ஈவன் இஃப் இட் டேக்ஸ் லிட்டில் பிட் ஆஃப் டைம் இட்ஸ் ஓகே. ஐ டோன்ட் வாண்ட் ஜம்ப் இன் டு சம்திங் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப்டர் டூயிங் சம்திங் ஆஸ் குட் அஸ் நீனா, ஐ ஆம் ஹோப்பிங் அண்ட் ப்ரேயிங் தட் ஐ கேன் டூ சம்திங் யூனோ ஆஸ் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் ஆஸ் இட் பட் கம்ப்ளீட்லி டிஃப்ரெண்ட், ஸோ தேட் யூனோ ஐ கேன் ஷோ மை வெரைட்டி ஆஸ் அன் ஆக்டர் அட் தி எண்ட் ஆஃப் இட். தட்ஸ் வாட் ஐ வாண்ட் டூ. So I'm just hoping and wishing and praying that I get some good scripts like that, but I'm still looking into some of them, and let's hope for the best. I'm the kind of a person, I don't really honestly get attracted to Bollywood, Tollywood or anything of that sort. As long as, you know, you get a role that you can perform to your fullest and can help people notice you, and you're in a position to do justice to that role, it doesn't matter whether it's in any industry. People do have a craze for Bollywood and Hindi, and definitely if tomorrow I get an opportunity to do something in Hindi, I would love to. But if you give me an option of a better script in another place and a not so good role in Bollywood, I would go for the script which will give me a better chance to perform and to be able to do justice in the right way. So I'm that kind of a person. So for me, Bollywood, of course, anybody would want to do Bollywood. I, in fact, would want to even go to Hollywood if you ask me. But you need the correct chance, you need the correct opportunity, and you need the correct path to reach there. So hopefully, yes, one day I will be able to fulfill that dream of mine also. But as of now, I'm happy doing what I'm doing, and I hope I can progress in that area also.